these pages could have words written on them, or they could have pictures or drawings. But each of these is like a page, and so you can read the book like this if you had happy birthday to you, happy birthday. It would be like a little book.
Mm-hmm.
Or then you could hang it on up in your room. You would put the bead down, and you could hang it somewhere like an ornament. So if you wrote a poem to somebody, you'd always remember what it was. So should we make one of these today? Would that be fun? So I have, so this is a star book. This one, the pages are joined in a different way. So it's like a big, long book that has, you know, two different sides. It has lots of sides with all these folded pages. You've done origami before? What have you made in origami? Animals or?
What's that?
Fortune teller.
The fortune teller, oh, right. This is sort of like a fortune teller because it sort of moves and opens a little bit, but not very much. So what we start off with, squares of paper, and each unit has a fold in it. So when you put them together, you can either make a long one like this, or you can have them fold so they go in a circle. What we're going to do, I'll show you how to fold. You watch first. So the way to fold this, for each of these, the units of the paper, we have five of them. We have a piece of paper and we're gonna fold it in half. So you can watch first and then we'll start folding. So we're gonna fold it in half one way, and what we wanna make sure is all this is lined up nice and straight. We sort of don't wanna fold it like this because then it won't sort of work. It won't fit together perfectly. But this way, if we have it right together, we're gonna fold it one way like this. So then we open it up, and keeping it the same top, we're going to fold it the opposite way. So if one's a vertical direction, one's a horizontal. So we'll fold it in half again. Perfect. Perfect. Now this is called a bone folder, and it's actually for making this nice and creased. We can run that up and down. If you want, you can use the bone folder. Do you want to use this one's super clean? This one's clean. Just to make your creases nice and sharp. Perfect. That's a bone folder that bookbinders use. And if you run it on the edge like this, it sort of gets the paper. So we sort of don't need to use the point, just that long edge. So now if we open that up, we have sort of two folds. So now we have four squares, right? This is the magic part. We're going to turn it all the way over. And now we're going to do two triangles. We're going to fold a point to a point to make a triangle. Exactly. And then you can use your bone folder just to make that nice and sharp, nice and crisp.
Just a little bit. Scrunch it, put it there. There we go.
And then you can use your bone folder. And then when we open this up, what's going to happen is if we push in the middle, it's going to want to fold in on itself and end up with just a square.
Wow.
So it just wants to pop. So this inside wants to poke in like that. So if you squeeze it like your fortune teller, and then these will come down like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to make five of these, and then we can put them in a circle. But you could either use the plain color or colored paper. You want to use colors instead of the white? Now that we counted out the white, well, white's pretty. But it's not always boring. It looks like snow. Like ice. Plus we could write on these pages.
Mm-hmm.
And then we turn it over and take those folds, and they're going to come together. These two folds in the middle, and then the flat edge comes down. So these two, I'm going to poke that middle out, and then these two folded edges come down. And that's your flat edge. And then, wait, and then let's push that down as a flat edge. Then you end up with one square. This is called a piece of scrap paper. It's just old paper that we're not going to use for anything. And I'm going to do a demonstration first. What we're going to do is we're going to put a piece of paper in there, and I'm fitting it right into the corner, because what I want to do is put glue just on this side. Just on this side of the paper, all along here. But when we glue like the rays of the sun. We're going to have the glue stick in the middle, and then we're going to point out. So all the arrows start in the middle and go out. I'll demonstrate. Because if I come this way, I'm going to get glue underneath, and then my book won't open because all the pages will be glued shut. So I'm going to screw this open a little bit. I'm going to start with the middle and drag it out to the edge. I want to make sure I'm getting all the glue to the edge, but I'm not going to come back in. I start in the middle, like the rays of the sun. Go out, out, out. And I'm going to make a star book. The next thing I do, I take out the piece of gluey paper, crunch it up, throw it on the floor. I don't want it on my desk, because as soon as I have a gluey piece, I'm going to put my good book down. It'll be stuck to it. All glue paper we throw on the floor. We'll pick it up afterwards. So if this corner has all the folds, see how there's an open corner? They want to stay open, but there's also a folded corner. To make the star book, all the folded corners go together, all in that point. And I'm holding my fingers like this and sort of getting it so it's nice and square, so they're going to meet up. Then I'm going to open it up. This is the page that was just glued together. Then I'm taking the side of the bone folder and rubbing it across to make that nice and stuck together. So now I have two pages starting of my star book. So the next time I do a piece of gluing, I'm going to put that open edge, put my piece of scrap paper in there. Like the rays of the sun, I start in the middle, go out, middle, out, middle, out.
This one here. Wait, she said to me.
So we want to come all the way out. I can see places where that needs more glue. See where it's not shiny? We want everything to be shiny. That's where the glue is. Now you're going to take out the piece of scrap paper. What are you going to do with it? Excellent. So now you want to get another one, and there's the fold, and there's the fold. Okay. So you want to put the two folded edges together.
We're going to do all of them.
So this corner comes up to this corner. And you're just going to make sure that it lines up. I'll try and line it up.
You want to bring it in.
This is a little tricky. What I do is I sort of hold it in my hands so it's resting in between.
And don't bring it back in.
And then it won't shift. And then I'm just going to align that corner. That's pretty good right there. Now we're going to open that up. And you're going to use your bone folder now to just go across.
Sorry, I'm not holding it as well as I should. There you go.
So you can press down, make sure that glue is getting all the edges stuck. Exactly. Now we're going to get the third one. So we'll put a piece of scrap paper right underneath there. And you can glue. You can glue that down from the middle out, from the middle out. Good. And then we'll open it up. And you're going to rub the white part that's stuck, just like that, right across there. Okay. Excellent.
Okay.
So then we'll close this up and we'll put another piece of scrap paper. So we have two more to glue, right? Because we have two more orange ones. So now you can glue it.
One more.
You need one more? Mm-hmm. Remember now, open it up and pass the bone thing on it. There you go.
Should we close it? And let's see if you have a star. Whoa, beautiful. There's your star. Now we're going to ask Mom in front of you, there's some weights. Those metal pieces, yes. Mm-hmm. If we can each have a weight. And we're going to put a weight on top of that and let it dry. Because now we need to make a cover. My Cricut is going off. These are hard pieces of two-ply. And they become the outside book covers. So we need to decide what color we want on these. And we're going to cover the two pieces of two-ply. So you need two. Your brother needs two, and then we have extras here.
This is marble paper.
Very pretty.
Whoa! What colors do you think?
Theo, what color do you want? You have orange inside yours.
Theo does like red. I don't know if
red?
He wants red.
Okay.
Theo, do you want red?
Theo?
Or pink?
I'm just
going
to guess
one. Okay. Sounds good.
Ooh, what about this one,
please? Anyway.
This is a beautiful card. Is this like embossed?
It is embossed. You know, it might be easier just to put that in the corner, and then you can draw two lines and just need to cut out two sides. I'm going to hold that in place. Maybe it's not square. Then we'll mark this. And then along that side. And then this doesn't really matter. Okay. And then you can cut on that pencil line. So what we're going to do is take our piece of scrap paper and then take one of your covers and take your glue. We're going to take off the board. We're going to turn this on the wrong side. This is probably the wrong side because the pretty design's on the up. And you're going to glue like the rays of the sun. Put glue all over your yellow piece of paper, your orange piece of paper. And we just want a lot of glue on there.
Middle out, middle out, middle out.
And put it right in the middle. So we want to make sure the edges are equal on all the sides.
Maybe up a little.
So it'll sort of move along there. There we go.
Towards here a little bit.
And then what do we do? What's next? We're going to cut off the edges of the triangles, right? This glue piece of paper, once you pick this up, I want you to fold that in half. Because now the glue's inside, and if I put anything down on there, it won't get stuck. If this is the board thickness, this is actually how thick the board is, I want to be out two board thicknesses from the corner, and I'm going to cut off these triangles. Because when we turn the page, the paper over, I want this covered. I know that was really technical, but it's how we start learning about bookbinding techniques. So what we're going to do is I'm going to draw lines here, and you can cut off these corners, okay, with the scissors.
She wants me to draw a line.
Well, if you can just, either way.
You can eyeball it.
You can eyeball it and just cut it. Here's some scissors.
Think you want to show
yeah, it's Patty? Enough because once it's turned under, okay. The other paper is going to go in. Now you're going to press down, you're going to roll it away, press down, and then you're going to roll it away. press that down and then flop it all the way over. And then you really want to just sort of rub that with your fingers. Good. Now you can press down this side and roll it up. Goes all the way over. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Now we have two more sides to do. And we need the bone folder. You're just going to sort of tuck that in with the bone folder. Sort of tuck it in.
And then now do the
at this
edge.
End, you can tuck that top. Yeah.
No, the other one.
That sort of tuck it in this way. There we go. Now we're going to turn this upside down and you're going to press down that side. Roll it over. There you go. Rub that. Now we have one more side. You're going to tuck it with a bone folder. Tuck those edges. Yeah. So what we want to do is we're just tucking that in. Tucking that in. There we go. And then turn it this way. Roll it over.
And as we do that one
press
now.
Down. Whoops. Okay. So the glue is starting to dry out too by the time we get into the end. So what I'm doing now is just sort of burnishing this. This is called burnishing. Now you can turn this over and go flap, rub it across there and come hit the corners with your bone folder. You're trying to really iron everything together so the glue sticks exactly. So we're going to glue all of that again. So we'll take the board off, the white board, and then you're going to glue like the rays of the sun. You may have to undo that a little bit. It's running out a little bit. Turn that. Yeah. Okay, let's see. I'm just going to make sure that we got enough glue on there. So I'm just going to come along and make sure all the edges are done. Like the rays of the sun, I'm always coming, starting from the middle, going out, middle out, middle out, middle out, middle out. All right, now that's ready. You can get your white piece of two-ply. I'm going to put that right in the middle so everything's equal. About like that, and then I'll draw lines for cutting off the triangles.
Right here, honey.
Okay, so you can peel this off and use the scissors to cut your triangles. Then this can come underneath, and we're going to lift this up and put the two gluey sides together and put that under the weight. Now what's left? Uh-oh, we need ribbons. Oh dear, now we need to choose some ribbon.
That's a beautiful. That's the one you want?
Mm-hmm. The green? Okay.
Oh, you want the blue, of course.
That one?
Also,
that one. Ooh, that's nice. We usually don't measure it, but we will measure it. So if you can cut 2 8-inch pieces, there's the 8. So we need 2 pieces that are 8 inches long, just about. Doesn't have to be exact.
The
Oh, wait, wait.
Oh, maybe.
I Actually, okay. I'm going to change my mind. How about 9 inches now that you've carefully measured this? We'll come up to 9. There we go. So 2 pieces that are 9. Hmm. And you can either do it this way where you measure one. And look, if I fold that in half and bring this right back down, then we'll have 2 equal pieces.
Oh, it's 9.
So you can do one cut there. Whoops. And then one cut right at the middle. That way we only had to measure once. So we're going to put the scissors right like that.
I don't think so.
2 9 pieces. Excellent. So there are those two. And then we need one piece that's, let's say, 2 inches.
Sorry.
Amazing.
Okay.
Excellent. Excellent. I'll hold this end, and then you can cut the other end. Cut it at the end of the... There. Excellent. Almost. Almost. There we go. Perfect. So then we have 2 long pieces and 1 short piece. Whoops. Now, I don't want to knock you off. Move over towards your brother a little bit. Oh, get down. Perfect. This is where all my tools are in there. Oh, tricky, huh? So we have 2 of these or 1? Well, we'll share. So we have this ribbon, but it's underneath our cover, and our star book's going to go on top. So the small piece will be at the folded end, and the 2 long pieces are where it opens. But what we have to do is we have to poke holes in our covers. And you can see how they're opposite. There are 2 holes in each cover. And what I want to do is poke a hole back towards the middle, about a quarter of an inch from both sides. So what we'll do is we'll take one of the covers, and I'm putting it on the board here. And I'm going to poke this in right about there. I'm sort of turning it, making this nice hole that comes right through. Do you want to poke one right about there, coming towards me? See if you can push this down and turn it.
What is this called? A dowel?
This is an awl.
Awl.
A-W-L. So that gets really pushed into the wood.
We have our board. I think maybe like around there.
Okay.
Let's put it on the board. Wait, and do it like that at an angle.
You have sharp scissors. Angle? You can do it that way as well. Because what we're going to do is you're going to poke this through this hole. I'll do one side and maybe you can do the other. We're going to poke that right through there.
Yeah.
Right, make sure that it aligns with
and then we're going to turn it over.
Yeah, that's
this is
good.
The tricky part.
Did you notice that you have a cut?
I do. I have
there
a
it is. Going it's going to come it's through. And then you know what I want you to do now is take your bone folder and press down on that hole. What that's going to do is going to close the hole. And it's going to make a nice closure on there. So there. That's nice and tight and glued down. I use the X-Acto knife to make a nice sharp point because now we're going to thread this like a needle into the board. And see, oh, drop it on the floor, throw it away, no worries. Whoa, there it is. See if you can poke that in there, that hole, so it'll come up that side.
So make a point on the ribbon.
On the ribbon, because we're using the ribbon like a needle, so you can cut on this green, it's a cutting mat. Grabbing that ribbon. And then we'll put a little bit of glue on the board. And then you can rub that ribbon down flat onto the glue. Perfect. Excellent. Excellent job. And you have one more, and that's going to go in that hole from this side. The outside. How are we doing down there? You need some help?
Yeah, we're having some
difficulties. Okay, we'll be right there because we are. You're gonna smush that.
Yeah,
but your bone folder.
Maybe try on the other side. Or yeah, try.
And then we'll put a little bit of glue, and then just let your.
Good job.
Surgery. Mm-hmm.
See, if that was nice and narrow, like a needle, then it's easier to pull it through. So now we're going to lay this down right here. I want you to take the bone folder and smush that hole closed. We're just tightening a girth on it so it'll keep it. You use the point and the point right on that hole. Just really... Totally perfect. Smoosh it. Yep. Then we're going to put a piece of glue right underneath, and you can pull that tail down with the bone folder just along the glue line, just like that. And then I'm going to go back and just smoosh that hole. So then we're going to repeat that on the other side, and you're going to do it in one of those holes. Okay, so that one goes in there. Good. Now you can poke it with your bone folder. Just pinch it.
You get all of those things right.
Good job. And then a piece of glue on there. Excellent. And then lay the ribbon down on top. Scare them away? Good job. Good. Right there. Yeah. And then where the small join, that small ribbon is, that's where all your folded pages go, right? Because all the folded pages are going to go there and then open up this way. So we're going to take a piece of scrap paper and put it under the top, and then like the rays of the sun, you're going to get glue all over that. Okay.
Towards the edge too. All it has to hold to the cover. What do we do with this? I'm just going to get a little more up here along the edge, because I can see if it's not shiny, it means there's not glue there. All right, so we've done that. Now you can get rid of that glue piece, and what do? Smush it and get rid of it. Excellent. So now this is the folded edge, and this is the gluey part. So the folded edge is going to go right to that little place at the corner. So you're going to put your book right in the middle here, up to that fold. And then when we open it up, you can use your bone folder, your finger, and you're just going to make sure that's nice and crisp. Nice, and you're really trying to burnish that so that you're coming right to that edge with the bone folder. You can go over with your bone folder, make sure there aren't any air bubbles. So we're really trying to iron the, get all the air bubbles out and make sure that glue is really adhering. It is all
I think it needs up in this area too. You use the flat of the bone folder.
Right here.
Yeah, that's right. Or the edge. The flat edge. Yeah, exactly.
The edge, you see, right at the edge here.
It just needs to come right up the edge.
There you go.
Now you're going to take out that piece of scrap paper. Smush it. And then this is going to come down, but the tricky part is when I do the cover this way, I'm holding my fingers one way. And I'm holding them the other way. What I'm trying to do is getting the two square. So if I go down like this and like this, the boards are going to be nice and square to each other, so that they're a nice cover. And then I don't know which one we just glued. We need to burnish. I think it's this side. Okay. This one, we need to...
And then you put it all the way in?
Make sure that it's all... getting all the air bubbles out and really adhering the paper to the cover. All right. Now we have a storybook. Almost. Now what do we need? Bead. So I have to find where the beads are. Or when it's closed and then when it's opened, I can slide the bead down. That keeps it open. So you can choose a bead from in there. The trick is not to get one that's too small, so it's hard to put on, but not too big that it falls off.
Needle. Pointing.
Oh, wait. Another trick. Sometimes take the awl and poke the hole. We're trying to get, there might be splinters in there. We're trying to make it smooth. So hold the awl on one hand, hold the bead in one, and sort of twist it around to sort of, yeah, and then do it from the other side. Right. Because there might be a little splinter that's catching the ribbon. Okay. Now see if you can thread these. Is that hard?
Whoa, almost.
Did you find another one? Then the trick is you have to hold both ribbons together.
This one.
Okay, the clear one. We have to put the both ribbons?
You do put both through. Excellent. So then what we want to do is tie a knot in here, but because of that hole, we probably need to tie a couple of knots. And do you know how to do a circle? And then basically we're going to do a circle and bring the tail through like that. No? Should I do it? And then I'm going to put the tail through again because I want the knot to be bigger than the hole. And then I'm just holding that and pushing it all up to one end. Because this way, the bead won't come off. Oh, it is going to come off. So we're going to do another knot. Just trying to make that big enough. There. Excellent.
You get both in at the same time.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
You put both in together. Look at that. That's excellent. That's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. Well done. Like this, we're going to do, I'm going to hold it. I'm going to make a circle. And I'm going to bring the tail in. I'm going to hold it at the very end of the tail and move that circle back up to the tail. I might do another circle and bring that so we have a double knot. And what I'm trying to do is make sure that this ribbon can't get off, which it can.
Okay.
Okay. That's pretty fancy. Look at that. It's beautiful.
What do you think, Theo? I like the colors you chose.
Gorgeous.